we move here on the course, so it's better for us. Today's topic is movement without the ball. So, starting from mini basket to the NBA, we have movement without the ball. The player with ball has just one goal, to score. Player without the ball or players without the ball also one. Get ball again and score again. So looks easy, looks simple, but of course now we will speak about movement without the ball, how to be ready to score if, when you are without the ball. So which kind of moves you should make when you are without the ball in order to be in better position the moment of the receive. So looks simple, but it's like this. And generally, when you speak about offense, we have general offensive principles: high percentage shot, transition, balance between inside outside game, movement, and of course in the end and in the beginning always execution, especially for young players. And young players are coming from mini basket to under 18, especially for them, like I already said, it's too important how they execute drills and movements. After that, it's up to them to have individual tactics to choose right movements in the right moment of the game. Developing team tactics, we have a couple of points before the start, so transition game, press offense, set offense against man-to-man defense, zone set offense against combination defense, delay or control offense, transition game from offense to defense or defensive transition, and special situations, short clock shots, defense against the screens, how to attack two players, how to make isolation on the top of the key side wing. So we should cover everything, just to have some big pictures about that. After that we will move on the motion, not motion of without the goal. Offensive goals, for me, I think it's also for all coaching youth program, try to score as much as possible from fast break and secondary break. We already spoke about reasons, physical preparation, improvement of individual technique and tactic at high speed, but also from opposite side, be ready to play against when you are in defense. So when we start to play one-on-one, we cannot speak that we want to improve just offense on defense. Good offense means good challenge for defense and opposite. So always we should think it that way. After that, proper condition for fast breaking competition systems. Players turnover during the game, tournament of session, define and respect player positioning and responsibilities. Balance between inside and outside the game, so your team should be ready to score under the basket and also on the perimeter. And of course, we concentrate on execution of any system, much more important than the system itself. So this morning we spoke about that. It's important what you play, but it's too important in your program how you play. So execution is key point for kids. So now we will start to speak about different situations, how to be ready to receive the ball and score when you are without the ball. Let's start immediately with the players. So point guard here, defense on him, player on position 2 here, big boy 5 over there, one player on the wing, let's say 4 on the corner. So first we have first situation for him. He is here without the ball, with the idea to receive the ball and score, and he has the player in the corner on the same side. So after that we will show different way of moves when he is alone on the side. So here we spoke yesterday about that, how to get open. In this situation, of course, he cannot use a lot of things because he has a teammate in the corner. So short space now, just try to receive the ball first, starting position. So if he deny, if you play enough and deny defense on him, he cannot start from here. because if he starts from here, he will receive the ball here. He cannot score, he cannot pass the ball to the big guy. So always go under. When under, depends on his shooting range. He should be able to shoot and to score from the position of the receiver. So if he is good in 3-point shot, here. If you start to do it under 12, under 14, they should receive the ball here. So depending on the shooting range of the players, you choose different starting positions. After that, we have technique. So play the night defense on him, be here on his position. Free step. So first, this is not the night defense. So I want to have your hand here like this and flexible when you deflect the ball. First, you come with outside foot between him. After that, one step in, and after that, third step outside, immediately face the basket. Because I don't like the players in position 2 and 3, 1, it doesn't matter when they receive the ball and they put the ball on the hip. So in that situation, you give the chance to defense to recover, because that is very important, immediately to face the basket. Of course, this is group tactic. So if the point guard is under the pressure here, press a little bit just to show the course, of course, cannot be affected two-hand pass. So you should go one step away from defense and try to pass the ball to him. Your responsibility is to show him. So just show the coach, come one step right foot inside, one cross, go out and face basket immediately. This is not good. So from this position you cannot shoot. So try to face basket immediately. So it's important also, even if you do good move, if it's not good pass, sorry, if you want to pass like this against defense, it's difficult, you know. So always all try to do this step or just one step away from this and left hand pass. Most of the time we can use from this position for point guard of the dribble pass. So try to dribble, change direction, pass the ball to him. Just slowly to show the technique. Now face the basket and be ready to shoot. So when you receive the ball on the ball side, you have three things to understand. First, receive the ball, so cover to get open. After that, read, defend the situation, and immediately attack. This is your job. So you cannot read situation if you have the ball here. So immediately face the basket depending on your shooting range, here, here, or here. If you are Reggie Miller, you can receive also here. But generally try to receive the ball close to the basket. Important detail about the angle. You know, for this position on the wing, I think his best position is the free throw line extent. Why? Let's go to receive the ball over there, go here. So here, it's great passing angle, great position, great line, pass the ball to the big guy. Some coaches prefer, I think it's very good to have same line, who is offense blue, go a little bit over there, on the middle post, Emma. So it should be the same line, both big guy and basket. I already showed you. If he's staying like this, it's lying not straight, it's easy job for defender on him. If he stays here, also it's too easy, after that he will go from this side. Of course, I don't want to speak now about three players' collaboration, high and low, but it's important always to have in mind, especially in your program, to have good position for playing one-on-one to attack, and also good position to pass the ball to the big guy who is under the basket. Go back. Reads in this situation. Pass ball to the point guard. We have a couple of options in defense. First option is back defense. So if you don't want to press the ball, you just go in, go out, and face the basket. And immediately attack. Now, when defender is coming to close out, you will read. If his left hand is up, you attack his back on this side. If his right hand is up, you attack on this side. So against back defense, I want to say that you are bad, just I want to show. So next situation, when he has, start from this position first, when defender is just with his hand on the passing line. So in this moment you come to me and you do like I already showed you before. But start first to move me down. So just with hand on the passing line, Generally, just get the ball and receive the ball and be ready to shoot. This is the second option for him. And third option is against denied defense, can be automatic. I think it's important to teach all players in all positions, especially in your program when you start to play maybe with five outside players or four out, one in, to find some way of communication. So, for me and for her, as a point guard, if the defender played the night defense with foot and with hand on the passing line, automatically he should make better cut. So we don't need to make some special communication, something like that, it should be signed. So in that way it's easy for us to understand, for him, but more for point guard in this position. So if you see that I'm like this, don't pass the ball before he's getting open. But if you can see just my foot here, of course, try to make backdoor cut. Technique, go back to defense, by denying with the foot on the way. So generally, good defense is staying one third from offense, so don't be too close, because now, from this, if you're playing like this, you cannot help on this driver. So move a little bit here, one third, foot here in front, more, like this. So in this situation you can control, stay low, this is not defensive stance, stay low, watch here, now you can see with peripheral vision everything. So now in this situation, of course, we speak more about offense. You're going first with outside foot out, and now you change direction if he comes to you, because usually he will now try to score. Now your second step cannot be, or you push with this leg. So generally what players do with backdoor cut? They cut and they go in this way. So this is not good, because in this situation it's easy for defender to recover. So you should attack his foot here. So if he play, if side play like this, so your first step should be here. And now even if he go, he's behind him. So it's very important to teach players immediately, because generally they run, but they don't run directly to the basket. So try to go immediately to close his right foot with your foot. He said try to go. Backdoor, of course, in this situation you use all the dribble bounce pass. Why bounce pass? Because excellent defense. I will try to be excellent. And not at so. They play defense here. So any direct pass can be deflected. So because of that, nobody played defense, move down, nobody played defense here. So because of that, it's important to teach him how to get open, but it's also very important to teach point guard to pass, bounce pass under. So just show to coach, you go with over, come in front of him, receive the ball, and after that you have space to do whatever you want. So just a couple of details. I repeat again, bad defense, who is not pressuring the ball, go down, come to him and go back. Defense just with a hand on the passing line, go in and out. Go in and out, catch the ball, be ready to shoot. And after that, third option, foot and hand on the passing line, backdoor cut. Okay. Of course, we have a couple of options here. If you play overplay defense with body check here, with body contact, we can check here. Of course, maybe it's better for me to use back pivot. So, if there is close contact, just to use back pivot here. Or to make swing move. So, play front defense. Or just to make swing move here, clean, bounce pass, please, left hand. Okay? You just forget. So, try to show to the coach. First, back pivot, if we start. Just back pivot. In this situation, you should change target hand. So here, target hand is left. When you make the move here, target hand becomes left, right, left. Okay. And same situation with swing move. You go first to give information to him that you want to receive the ball. Put your antenna out. Show target hand here. If he reacts like this, just move here and try to catch it. Even if you don't want to touch the contact, just go over. It's very useful also under the basket when the big guy is playing. So, and try to attack directly to the basket. Don't make semicircle. So try to attack After that, of course, is coordination between point guard and bigger. This is the first situation. So he should be open in small space with teammate on the corner. Now let's move on opposite side, please. Here, of course, it doesn't matter if you speak about player on position 2, 3 or 4. When he is alone on this side, you have more options. Classical V-cut, start from here and go to receive the ball. Throw, receive the ball. Attack, be ready to attack immediately. Again here we have order. Getting open, so receive, read and attack. On the help side, we will have different order of moves. It's important to teach players a new program. I already showed you in perimeter player session that inside and outside move cannot be on the same line. So you should cut his way. We cut can be made in two directions. So come here and go out. Or if you come from here, come here, try to play and go here. So, but never do it like this, because this is the common mistake that kids do it like this. They come here, they go back here, the same direction, they can run 20 minutes like this. Easy for defense, and he cannot receive the ball never from this position. Of course, starting from the corner, you have also options with L cut. Try to show go directly to the low post. Stop. Immediately he start to make shortcut. So L cut should be usually with left foot inside the paint and after that go up. Let's go. Now this is not L, this is V. So L cut means that you go here, try to put inside foot here, go here. This way, and now, this last moment, try to put inside foot, not elbow, only foot inside and go, be ready to receive the ball and attack. So, try to show you, coach. You are always ready to pass the ball to left hand. Of course, after that, it's up to you, it's key point, attack immediately, because one of the most difficult situations for defense is transition from on the ball of the ball to on the ball defense. So when he should change, first he guard the player without the ball, after that when he comes close out, he should read and attack him. If you put the ball on the hip, you're not a good offensive player. So you give chance not only to him, but also to the players on the help side to jump to the ball and be ready to help you. So your job is to attack immediately and try score. Let's try to do it now, full speed, if you can. So try to get it open, receive the ball and attack. It's just one on one. Go inside, attack immediately. Good defense. Good defense. Let's try again. Play normal, listen, don't let him receive the ball. So immediately he should attack. I don't want to speak about it at all. But please don't go short corner, never. Because you are a guard. So this is the one situation. Last situation here against defense, when you have space in the corner, it's when you play here to jump in the corner, to receive the ball here and now, or attack here immediately, or make cross steps here. Solutions after that. It doesn't matter if you have the player in the corner or not. When you receive the ball here, generally best way to attack is cross step here. I showed you yesterday that it's important to teach players to put the ball on the floor practically. Because if you receive the ball here, if you want to clean just like this, your legs are not so flexible. So it's very important when you receive the ball to put the ball under his hand or hands. Because now watch my position, I am now ready to sprint. So it's very important that, because if you take the ball like here, if you want to play elbow game, that means that you are extended in this, so you cannot start. Try just to show left hip low. Okay, try to put the ball low. It doesn't matter, just receive the ball and try to move. Yes, this is the move, but what he missed? His first dribble, it was like letter U. His first dribble, it was here. So it's important to teach him to attack legs, so first dribble here, directly to the basket. Okay, don't go like this because you give him chance to recover, but also you give chance to the player from the help side to recover. Let's try to go directly to the basket. So straight line to the basket when you receive the ball. Yes. Try to score. Let's just score. We show just what you want to show to coach. It's important also, but technically, sorry. It's important also when you receive the ball before the start to protect the ball with your body. So here you put first foot and after that you push the ball with hand behind. Okay, just slowly try to demonstrate. It's too high. Under your knees, all under your knees. Let's go on. Just slowly, not practice, just they want to show difference. Yes, and now directly attack him. Next situation. He beat his opponent, but now, especially for players in position 1, 2 and 3, it's very important to teach them how to read first and second help in defense. In this situation, generally, let's be a little bit more here, you stay in our there, you stay on the low post. So generally defense is like this, when she passed the ball to him, normal defense play here in a flat triangle position. So now, I prefer from my guard, always, we already talk about that, always when he wants to pass the ball to the big guy, to use bounce pass. Because when he starts here, my hands are here. So we speak about big guys, 2 meters, so they can deflect the ball here. But if we put the ball on the floor, it's very difficult. Maybe just relax. Maybe help just one time, 10 penetrations. So now I'll try to come to help. Of course, good help. Good help comes here, and they close here outside of the paint. It's not good help here because here just basket and one free throw after that, usually. So you now do the same, just let him receive the ball, let him drive in the middle, and now use left hand bounce pass. Of course, after we will speak about the movement of the player, the low post when he drives in this direction. Next option for him, when he received the ball, because even if he drives here, sometimes he didn't beat his opponent completely. So in this situation, it's good to make step back, and now or he comes back, now I can do whatever I want. It's difficult, but it's one of good options for one-on-one situation for guard. So try to make, just let him go. First try to make step back and continue on the same side. After that, step back and cross over in the middle. Just slow. From the beginning, everything. Just slow. Try to receive the ball, let him go in the middle. So now his idea is to make separation, to separate from defense and after that to attack. Now do the same. You jump, close out, cross over in the middle. Step back, cross over. He separates, yes. Okay, next solution for him, how to beat big guy. Of course, if he is good in offense, if he beat him completely, I prefer for my guys to stop here and shoot using the backboard. Even if they recover, I have option to pass the ball here or go back to pass. I don't like too much penetration, especially for point guards layup, because we have not this little bench game. All 3 points or layup. So it's easy for you after that, even if you cannot find good solution, it's easy for you to make reverse pivot and pass the ball back again. But generally, if this defensive helps come later, so now try to help here. So don't be good defender, be bad defender. In this situation, we have also some options for him. Up and down, pass here, or same situation with reverse field. So if I jump here, it's his help with leg, I can do like this, pass the ball to him, bounce pass again, and pass there. So this is the read of the first help. Of course, after that, we will speak about the help side. Okay, let's go back, Emma, here. So, options for the players, just for him. No screens, this is individual technique and tactic. But also, in this set, we have also how to read defense from the help side. So, it's very important to teach them, because usually we don't pay attention too much how they do later. it's important to beat this, but after that it's over. If you cannot find a good solution, you are dead, even if you made good jump here. So now next situation, go out, please. With five players, pass and attack, or classical give and go situation. So, when she has the ball here, when pass the ball to this guy, typical mistake for offense is to lift your body center gravity and after that to do something. Because players are lazy. They don't want to jump immediately and receive the ball. We start from the first sentence. When I become player without the ball, my first idea is to get the ball again. So you cannot get the ball again if you pass the ball to him and now you stand. So together with the ball, you should make something. Defensive options, like before, take ball please. Back defense is just stay here, because also for defense is common mistake, go back please, that when she pass the ball, take the ball and pass the ball to him, back defense is trying to do it like this. It's easy for her now to go or front door cut, go back, or back door, because I'm like chair, like con. I'm just watching, so it's easy. Now you can go back or come from this side. Okay. Like I showed you before, a couple of options defensively how to read. If she passed the ball over there, if I move here, just E move, go here and go back. And now when I start to come, you read my situation, you attack. This is the second option, defensively, and I'll of course immediately answer for offense. And third option, when she passes the ball, good defense, jumps to the ball. It doesn't matter if you cannot score, try to go immediately, because in this situation, maybe you will receive backdoor pass, but also if you not receive the backdoor pass, you lift his space for him to play one-on-one. So it's very important also, because after that, it's teamwork, so you should help. So, same situations for all positions. Even if you pass the ball from here, same situation here, pass ball to corner, same reads, but key point is flying together with the ball. So when the ball is leaving your hands, immediately attack. I prefer attack the defensive player immediately, don't make fake move. Because if you make fake move, let's do it like this, you fake first here and after that go back. Pass ball, take the ball. Pass the ball to her, now a defensive jump, now try to go here, so it's easy jump for me. But if he starts to attack me immediately, go to attack immediately, it's not so easy for me. Even if I'm a good defender, I must choose left or right. If I'm jumping here, he will go back door, of course. If I'm just pass the ball to him and pass ball, if I'm just staying and watching, it doesn't matter, it's important that start before to me. Because it's very important to make this transition from on the ball to off the ball. Defensively it's very difficult, but offensively it's too easy to beat them. So this is very important to teach the players how to do it. Let's go now, if you got any question about this. Okay, let's go now to speak about collaboration with the post. Go to the low post, please. Same pass and attack move. So, if I get the player on the low post, if I pass the ball to him, I should immediately run. Orientation can be elbow. So I should touch elbow with my outside foot, try to go here. Of course, bounce pass. Sometimes happen that complete defense, just fake defense. Okay. So, when I pass the ball and when players go here, if they don't receive the ball, they move. Your head. So wait for the late pass under the basket. Only when you go on this level, on the level of the basket, only there you can move on opposite side. Because usually defense is concentrated on this first step. So what's happening if you go in offense? Pass the ball to him. So go to jump. I'm ready here. So now I think what's here. He's not passing to him. Easy jump for me. But in the end, he can receive also late pass under the basket. Of course, bounce pass. This is a good option for him. opposite situation when he's on the high post. Of course, I'm running here, but immediately I'm running here, if I can receive, yes. If I cannot receive the ball, I'm moving the opposite side to let him place to play one-on-one. Okay, this is the for post-collaboration. Of course, now let's see how we can read the situation for the post. Go back on the middle post. So, when I pass the ball to him, like I told you, always we should speak about offense and defense. So, if I pass the ball to him, what defense can do? So, if he don't watch the ball, if he just watch me, what I will do? Just cut and go away. Okay, but never be at the same position. Maybe cut here or maybe cut here, but in the end, I just want to make move because I want to let him to play one-on-one. Second situation. Defense can play yo-yo defense. So going offense. Defense pass the ball to him. Defense can go to help and go back. In this situation, it's very important to teach the passer or score shooting guard, 2-3-1, doesn't matter which position is in youth program, definitely, and B5 also. So to attack back of defender, because he should move. Even if I turn just my head to see the ball, you should watch ball at me. So even if I turn like this, you should move. Sometimes it's just enough one step to move. In which direction he should move? So, if he move in this direction, pass ball to him, it's easy job for me because I don't need to change direction. But if he pass the ball to him and move to corner, now watch my move. I should move this side or this side is too difficult for me. So, passer who become a player without the ball should attack always back of defender. Of course, it's completely opposite. Pass the ball to him. If I play this way, it's always better for you to attack my back on this side. Because, pass the ball here and go to corner, please. If he goes over there, it's good for me to have ball in the corner, short space, some double, or just one-on-one plays. It's much better for him to receive the ball over there under the basket than him. So because of that, it's very important to teach player here to attack back. Last option. Defensively is when he pass the ball to him, that defense goes to double. When defense double, same situation for him. Banana cuts around the 3 point, be ready to shoot the ball immediately after the back pass. So in any way you should go. So when you pass the ball, you cannot stay because best situation for defense is what? Just stay when you pass the ball, stay. So I can control here, I go back, easy jump for me. Just without knowing, just with hand, I can do everything. Especially big guys, 2 meters here, they can cover everything. So because of that, even if I jump here, he should move in this position, be ready to receive the ball, to shoot or pass the ball again to the big guy. So always move, because always I get back 10 times during this session in the beginning. When I am player without the ball, my job is to receive the ball and score. I don't want to hear offensive player and defensive player like headball and ice hotel. All 5 players should be ready to score points. Okay, any question about this? Nothing? Okay, take ball over there. Now let's speak about the help side players. When the ball is over there, we have 2 players, 2 offensive players on the help side. There are several rules for them. First, let's be good helping position, you and you. So, in this situation, they should be in flat triangle like this, with both hands here, 1/3 of him, but ready to left their play the ball. And also, you are in the same position. This is your player, so you should be ready. Here to maybe to help, depends of your of defensive system of rotation with which player you want to help. But anyway, ball is over there. Ball can score. In this situation, Emma and guy here, they cannot score. So information for the players on the help side is always play defense, 5 players against ball. Don't don't be here and watch here the player directly, and after that is different game, of course not. So in this situation we have some rules for the players on the help side. First of all, it's better to stay on the help side than coming. I will explain later some exceptions, some different situations. Why? Because if I'm here, he can control me, player can check with me, and also watching the ball. So it's easy job for defense. If I'm here because he control me, please go in offense, he can check me what he can and watch the ball. It's too difficult now when Emma is in the corner. Now he should watch the ball, but also sometimes be there. Of course, best situation like this, but it's not so easy. So I should put him in that situation. We speak about the offensive player on the help side. Same situation here. So if he is here, come to make contact with him, easy job for him. So if he control him with contact, then he can be ready to help on opposite side if he drive and something like that. So for players here, because of spacing is in offense too, it's very important to be on the help side. So don't come in the trouble in the middle. After that, I will show you some exception. When they need to cut in the middle, when they need to make flash cut the ball. So first, when the players, defenders on the help side are too much under the passing line, so in this situation, Emma, you can cut in because he is here. Sometimes players just watching the game, they are not defenders, they are fans. So here, of course, sensing. So in this situation, when you see that he's just watching like this, make flash cut, pass the ball to here to score. This is the first situation, same on this position. If he's staying like this, watching the basket, flash cut in the middle, shoot the ball or drive, whatever you want, anyway. Second situation is when the defenders on the help side are too much over the passing line. So if he's staying like this, go here. If you don't watch, so you can see how many times in NBA, also in EuroLeague, Rudy Fernandez, how many times he done from this after the middle pick and roll with Julio or Sergio Rodriguez there, because his player is staying like this, just in this situation, flash of the ball. Bounce pass or lob pass or press is good space. Also here you play normal defense. But if he is staying like this on the passing line or above the passing line, of course you will not wait on the help side, you will come in to flash the ball. Same situation against zone defense. Try to come into the gaps in the zone defense, but it's the same principle like here. So, like I said before, first goal for the players on the help side, be on the help side. Don't come into the middle. Second goal is open passing line. So, for example, if point guard is here, defender is here, so you cannot be at the same line with your teammates. Just once, because from this position, watch this position, so they are on the same line. So your job is to open passing line. Just one step. Down or up. Because player with the ball should have four passing options, not two or three. Also here, for example, sometimes we have the player stay on the high post, please. So if he's staying on the high post, this is not a good position for me. I should go or down or just move here. So in this situation, I open four passing options for the player with the ball. Go back on the low post, please. After that, next situation is how to attack when you receive the ball. Before, when we spoke about the players on the ball side, we said that when he receive or she receive the ball, he should receive the ball, read the defensive position and attack. Here we have different order. So, when the ball comes, can be skip pass, go back, or quick swing pass. So in this situation, he should be able to read defensive position during the ball flight. So he should read, receive and attack. Not receive, read and attack like before. Because especially with long passes, try to pass the ball to him in the corner. So, staying in this position, she has the time to read position because of the defender, because he's vision field. Pass the ball. So I can hear now, I read and immediately I should attack him the moment of the receive. So, mistake is that players don't watch him, they receive the ball, and now when he camps, they try to play one-on-one. It's too late. So, defender should be beaten in the beginning. In the moment of the receiving, you should have an idea of how to attack him. We have a couple of reads here. First read, so pass the ball to him. Bad defense, don't jump, shoot the ball. Pass the ball to him, receive and shoot immediately. Yes, catch and shoot. Here we have one individual tactical detail. When players are without the ball, when they must receive the ball, they shoot it with feet in the air. That means jumps to the ball. When you pass the ball, feet on the floor. Because it's completely different, especially here, pass the ball to me. If you receive the ball like this, especially for 3-point, or pass the ball to me, or jumping to the ball. So now he's ready to shoot, to drive immediately. If he receives the ball just like this, for 3 points, what he can do? He's not ready, absolutely. So first situation also can be interesting now to teach players in this position to read hand position. So, if I'm defender, I will play in your place. If I'm defender, if I play with good footwork, but if I take my hand here, please shoot the ball. You are shooter, it's up to me to decide when I want to change you, but your job is to shoot the ball. If you don't shoot the ball, you are not too. So, change sport, going to play handball or something else. So, offensively, defensively, first option, late defender, shoot, or defender with hands down, shoot, always. After that, next option. A late defender who want to make fly by, so pass the ball. I want to fake here, just wait that my feet leave the floor and drive in opposite direction. Same thing on the opposite side, I fake something, sometimes better, especially on the corner. When you have extra pass in the corner, players from him sometimes takes. And good defender, pass the ball to him. Good close out, ball here, now what I should read. When I was a player, it was a long time ago, coach teach me to watch which foot is in front. But definitely it's impossible. Because pass the ball over there, play defense, I will be on your place. Ball is low pass is coming, low pass. I cannot watch the ball up and see the foot here. So, theoretically, it's correct to do watch foot, but how? I'm asking you, how can I watch foot and watch the ball, incoming ball from this side? So, because of that, my idea is to watch which shoulder and hand are ups. Because what's happening, what can happen in this situation? Pass the ball to him. Of course, if I lift my if I put my right shoulder and right hand here, he will attack immediately, this way. So watch my shoulder, pass the ball to him, if I put here, he will attack my back from this side. And usually defenders put same from the same side, shoulder or hand and leg. Because if defender put like this, right hand, then well, he is dead, you know, he cannot react, or opposite. So because of that, it's, I don't know, most of the time it's just enough to see hand. Because when defender, like I show you, stay like this, you can attack me here, my foot, or you can attack my back here. So, like I said, most of the time, right shoulder and right hand need also right foot. And it's too easy for players to teach them to watch hand and shoulder than foot, because with long passes, with intensity, I cannot watch like this. So in the moment of the receiving, you should be ready. Let's go now, try to check his abilities. You can choose late, fly by, or lift right.
try to attack him immediately and try to jump to the ball. One more detail. In this situation, player with the ball should be in triple threat position without the ball. So be ready to shoot, shoot in pocket, ready, just jump and be ready. We have a couple of options here. How to stop? Tactic of stopping. Options. Two contact this way. Two contact like this. Just this. Or jump stop. So science shows us that jump stop is too quick. With jump stop, you load your legs with vertical energy. But maybe most important reason is because with jump stop you can use both foot as a pivot foot. So I prefer to use jump stop always when you receive the ball on the helm side. Because of that, because you know how many times happened that players, especially in the program, when they receive the ball, and they receive, for example, left-right, when they want to start hit for a direct step, firing. So it's better to be ready. Jump stop in this situation, it doesn't matter which shoulder is up, I can attack with cross step, left and right. So individual tactic of stopping on the help side can be interesting. Let's go. Try to read, so he drive, and he shoot. Okay, try to show now right hand. So attack immediately. This is the key point, because if we change five times ball side without attacking from the help side, nothing will come. Why we play basketball? Especially players in position 2 and 3. They are usually in this position, so they should be like sharks. They want to score. Scoring mentality. If they are not shooters, if they don't want to score, they are not 2 and 3. Change players. Because for them, it's key point to score. His first job, position 2, please score 20 points. How? Find a way. So this is about, of course, same situation on the court. Absolutely the same. So when she received bounce pass, jump to the ball, Emma, jump to the ball and wait. Of course, this is not so excellent position. This is not good position because from this position she cannot drive on the baseline, so she should be here on the level of the basket, ready to drive in the middle and ready to drive to make baseline drive. So this is about help side players, how to read, how to receive and how to react. Same reads we have with when you receive the ball, go to the post, Tema. You are here, pass ball to him, just back pass to her, and after that pass back. So now same situation. I prefer from all frontal pass to make jump stop. Frontal pass is just this and help side, nothing else in the game. Because usually players receive the ball from some lateral move, V cut, tail cut. In this situation, they can use two contact stop. Because you cannot go out of the diamond and jump like this. But from this position, go to help and go back. Go help. Now, when he comes, jump stop, ready to shoot, ready to attack here, and ready to attack here. Because of pivot foot. So it's very important to teach players, especially youth program. Some question about this. I repeat, rules for the players on the ball side, on the help side. First, stay on the ball side, on the help side. After that, open passing line, receive the ball in jump stop or one contact stop, and during the ball flight, read, receive, attack. And I show you for reads how they should read situations here. Okay, any question? No? Let's go now to speak about the circle move. Go out, please. Penetration and kick. Very important for all levels of the basketball, but especially for kids because they have not so much information about the spacing. In basketball, all of young kids, they want to be close to the ball. but it's not good. Of course, we should teach them from the beginning, starting with, let's call shell, with five outside players, how to react on the dribble drive. This is classical, you know, I'm sure everything about that, but I will try to give you full package of this. Circle move, what's mean? Means always when you drive one direction, all five players should move in the direction of the dribble drive. So if I'm driving from this position, first spacing, this is a good spacing. First of all, I can play one-on-one because nobody can help. Play the night defense. So I have space to play one-on-one. Even if I'm not so good in one-on-one, when I start to drive, they should rotate. Why in this direction? Because this is completely opposite direction of defensive rotation. So when I drive here, backdoor, corner, safety man here. Let's try to show situations now. You go, same move, you go in the corner, you go to help on me when I drive. So when I drive here, watch out. Defender is going to go back, it's about you. So go back, everybody, I will play in your place, just put the ball to the point guard over there, relax. So if defender is going here to close, I should escape from him. I'm going away from him, because after that, if I'm just staying in this position, go help and recover. Watch now, it's easy for him in two steps to help, but if he goes to help, I'm going here, go backdoor. So now it's very difficult for him because it's 6 meters. This is the first step. Of course, in youth program, you should start to teach your players maybe to help from first pass. But in older categories, nobody wants to help because it's too easy shot for the shooters on the ball side. So let's show now a situation that you don't want to help, you go to help for me. So in this situation now, with good spacing, when I'm going to go here, he goes to help or bounce pass, or if he is Rudy Fernandez or something similar to him, when I pass to him, he's passing. Never pass the ball chest pass on the level of the hands of the defender. Only two passes. When your players make mistake, stop immediately. So let's try to do again. First bounce pass, you just follow him. You do the same. When she put the dribble on the floor, it's sign for you to go. Sometimes in the games happens that she put dribble here, we start to rotate, but when she changed direction, Emma backdoor. Same situation, so always same side, like dribble drive. So let's go now, you go to help, first pass, bounce pass for him, and after that, low pass. Okay, just let him go. So in this situation, this is good pass or low pass. Passing technique, always off the dribble. Because what will happen, if I'm going like this, if I stop, it's not good. Even if they go and play extra defense, okay, I can change, go back, pass to him and play again. So never stop dribble, especially players in position one. Now pass, long pass, but off the dribble. Off the dribble, you can use two techniques. You can pass like this, go back, or from here. So two techniques, up and down, pass the ball. Same situation. On this side, of course. And if she drive here, you can go over there. Next situation, play there. Circle move when the players start to go from here. If I'm driving in the middle, same situation. Emma backdoor, you corner, you 40 grand, 45 degree, you are safe. Let's start from the beginning. First option, let's go you to help on me. So he start to go, watch now distance between him and her. Easy to shoot the ball. Now we have one situation difficult. I already show you. With extra pass in the corner, I show you 3 days ago. Generally, defenders is coming like this. That's true, because you have rotation. So this situation also bounce pass or away from him. Let's do it again from the beginning. So when you receive the ball, don't pass the ball to him like this, but try to make outside can't pass. Okay, let's go. Drive in the middle, pass the ball, stop. Not this pass, definitely the right hand, left hand of the dribble. Stop immediately with kids. If you stop first 3 months, after that you will be good for all life. So it's better to stop in the beginning, because if they form bad habits, after that it's impossible to change. So when you receive, pass the court to him. Let's go. Try to do it. Now he's coming now, watch. This is the good. This is a good pass, so away from Gibson and pass to him, and you are ready to shoot. Next situation. Next situation, now you don't want to help, don't help me, you go to help on me. You do the same, you do the same. So when I start to dribble here, easy pass for him to shoot the ball. Or, if he's a good shooter and he don't want to help, go to help you on me. Now I'm going in the middle, or pass here, or back door, or long pass here. Same situation. When we start from this position, so I will hold me. From this position in the middle, same. Emma back door, you corner 45, you go over there. So let's go. You first start to kill money. So when I drive here, so he escaped from defense, now he's free to shoot the ball. Let's go back. Now you go on your man, you go to help. I'm coming here. Watch now how is good situation, open court. Even bad players can find good solution because they have space. Now you go to help. You go to help. Watch now. Easy. And now you go to help. You go to help. Emma Becker. So it's circle ball, classical circle ball that you need to do always something like that. Now let's speak about baseline drive, because baseline drive we have one little adjustment. So if players from the corner start to make baseline drive, following circle move, she too should escape over there. But now the baseline drive is a little bit different. So when he drive here, if he go, you should be open there, so after the baseline drive, four passing options should be. First, so it's just different for players on the opposite corner. So, Emma, you just should be ready to receive the ball there. You just move on 45 degrees, you go behind me, and you go here on the elbow level of the 3-point line. So, four passing options. First, baseline pass, I prefer bounce pass, I already told you because of hands, because we have two hands here and two hands from here, so it's better pass the ball with a bounce pass. Somebody can say it's too slow, yes, it's too slow, but in this situation we practically have two offensive players and one defender. So if he chooses to go there, I will pass to him. But anyway, it's important to have space. So this is the first pass, baseline pass. Second pass is 40 degree pass, so you go to help on me, you go down to post Emma. This way, in this situation, especially with players from position 4, it's a good option to make flash cut to the ball and to dunk or to score easy basket. So let's go now. When you see, because always you should teach your players without the ball what they need to see. Ball and direct open. If you see that he goes to help automatically, you go up. Not too much rules. Maybe sometimes looks difficult, but believe me, it's not so difficult. After two practices, they will catch idea. After that, of course, day by day, you should prove that. But it's not so difficult, and we have not so many options. Circle move, only one. Baseline drive, only just one adjustment to the corner. So now you go to help on me, you try to close Emma, and you go flash to the ball, watch now, it's easy score for him. Now you go to rotate on him, you stay on your man, you will be ready to shoot the ball. 90 degree pass, when I try here, if they close everything, pass here, easy. If he goes to help, pass here if he goes to help Emma along the corner. So good spacing is key. Of course, we have the same options also when you play Final Five at the high level. Because starting from mini basket to the NBA final, we have drive and kick. It doesn't matter if drive and kick come immediately or after five pick and rolls. So always the same. So because of that, it will be easy in later part of career to teach them something special. But if they understand rules of spacing, timing, and passing option, because now we teach our offensive players also to read first, second, third, and fourth help. This is important, you know? Individual tactic. And last option, now, full rotation, you go on me, Emma, you go, and you go to stop here, you go behind me, and to shoot the ball. Let's go. They close me, very good defense, watch now. Especially with one screen here, easy jump to shoot the ball. Okay? And one more idea on the baseline drive. Generally, when the players drive here, go, and when the player pass the ball over there, generally players stops here. But more defensive player than offensive. So in this situation, go to help. I don't need to stop. I must to continue to make circle cut. Emma, go in the middle, we dribble. And now I'm always alone here, because nobody will start to follow me after that. I remember it was Nick Kalates from Panathinaikos. A lot of times we find good shoot from me, also the Matids, because they have good spacing. So they pass the ball, they continue, she continue in the middle, because of course when you receive the ball from this position, all defense is concentrated down. So your penetration cannot be again down, because you have incoming help from this side. So when you receive ball from here, you should attack here. Of course, circle move again. And after that, when he drive ball this way, try to do you. Go back in your position. Emma, go in the corner. When you receive the ball from baseline, just drive in the middle, you continue to receive the ball in the corner. Okay? Master, just continue to play. Watch now, who we call him? In this situation, what will we do? What is his job? He will come to help on this drive. And this man is alone in the corner for sure. Not for sure, but most of the time. Because not in his shoes, basketball, you know, but just to say. Okay, let's try now to play. Let's try to play 5-5. Just pass the ball around the shell. When you heard my sign, try to attack. And try to play normally to find good shooting option. Just to see if they can catch immediately then. Okay, let's go. Just move the ball around. No, it's not good option. He was alone, she was alone over there. Again, wait for me. When I clap my hands, try to attack. Okay, wait for me. Let's go. Too late. He was late. So when he drive there, you should be on the backboard. So it's not so easy, but after that, they will start to do it with right time. Believe me, after 2-3 practices, looks much better. Let's go. Let's go. Move, move, move. Now, individual tactic. Do you remember from before? Never pass the ball with feet in the air. So from this position, pass the ball to me. I receive the ball, I attack here. This is definitely not a good pass. So from this position, they close well in defense, he was there. Okay, so passing technique. Of course, we cannot run any 5-on-5 game without good fundamentals, but also playing this, you should stop and teach the players, show them right options, nothing else. After that, it's up to their intelligence, how they will use or not. Let's go. Let's go one more time. Don't move, don't move. Just stay there, not move. Go back. Stop. Too late. As soon as she put the ball on the floor, you should be here. Immediately. Go back in the middle. The middle pass. Let's start to drive. So this is completely different. This is completely different than he drive over there. One more time. Let's try to attack to score. Don't play just to show to court. Try to score and try to find a good solution, of course. Try to have some more passes. Don't shoot after the first pass. Try to move the ball on, and also, if you are not free, try to attack again. So when you receive the ball after the drive, first drive, try to drive again. If you are not free to shoot. Okay? Let's go. Pass the ball around. Pass ball around. So watch now. Who was free? He missed. He missed and he missed. In this penetration, let's go. I'm going to take ball here on the corner. Drive in the middle. You should be here and you should be in the corner. Watch now spacing. Completely different. Let's go again. Let's go again. Emma, again to the same. Pass the ball here. Let's go. Drive in the middle. So now it's completely different. Watch now, somebody's alone. Watch him on the corner. So, it's important to teach them offensive fundamentals, but also it's important to teach them how to read first, second, third, and fourth defensive rotation. Okay, one more time, and after that we will switch to big guys. Switch the ball, so somebody is alone, no problem. I didn't show you just collaboration between baseline drive and 45 degree. It's also the same like baseline drive here. So, if player from here drive, so you should be in the corner. So, anyway, don't move. Now, if I'm driving for here, don't come inside. Be ready to receive the ball, because what is my goal? If defender try to do it, you go to him. Put the ball here. So even if we made baseline drive from the 45 degree, we should have played in the corner. Watch now. In this situation, we have one against two. So because of that, it's important, of course, it's up to him to decide. If he goes to rotate here, go here, of course, this is a good option. Or, go back. If he wants to stay on his man, in that situation, of course, he can go over there or he can go to another basket, because depending if he's shooter, he will be on the free point. If he's big guy, player on position 4, 5, or somebody who has not so nice shot for the free points, of course, he has space to jump. But his jump is too easy because he has good vision. He can see everything in front of him. So your job is just when he goes to help to watch him and watch the ball. Not against. Let's go now. You go to help and you choose. Or here, and you must read situation. Okay? Stop. It's too late. When the ball is over there, you are not here. You are here. Yes. Not here, because you cannot see here. Flat triangle, one or two steps under the passing line. And now from this position, you can see both of them. Okay? Now when you go to drive, of course, from the first pass, never good help comes because it's easy for offense after one dribble drive and kick to shoot. Let's go to help and you try to find a new man. So in this situation it wasn't a good choice. He was there, you should pass over there. You just follow him. So now pass the ball to him. Again, this pass, but this. So now you go point guard defense. You go to help. You go to him and you go to him, you'll be ready to receive safety pass behind him. So circle ball, let's go. This is drive, watch now. Who can cover? Nobody. So it's really easy if you teach your players to move with the good spacing and with good time. What's mean time? Just start to move when the player with ball put the ball on the floor. It's really not so complex. But it's very important to catch a good time. So now we have one more situation about the collaboration with the post. Go please on the low post. rules for inside players. Same. We have, let's say, post line. What is the post line? Line parallel with the baseline, where is the post? So in this situation, your post line is, let's say, blue line. So level of the post. If penetrations goes above the post line, he should move in short corner. So if I'm trying here, you go to help, just one step. But when you start to move, let's go play on him, I will play on him. So in the moment, it's very important against simple move but time. Drive in the middle, you go to help. When he go first step, he's I'm here. Receive the ball and I'm shooting under the basket. So always same rule. I'm watching ball and I'm watching my direct opponent. He's going up, you go just one step down. Let's try to. So just one step is absolutely enough. Of course he cannot be here under the backboard. Here in this position, ready just with pivot to catch the ball and to score. Let's try to do it again. Yes, of course, from, pass the ball to me. Same situation from top of the key. So, when I drive here, you go on your position. If he goes to help on me, I can pass here, of course, or lob pass. But when I want to pass the ball, mistake in youth program is, so players want to pass the ball now. Not now, it's too late because he's a big guy. As soon I can see that he comes to me, I should pass the ball. So first step, now. Now it's very difficult for him to flip and also you move in opposite side. Of course, in this situation with the top of the key penetration, let's move on this side when I drive on left. You can go also on the short corner on the opposite side. Okay? So you do your job. Let's go. Now I can go like this too. It's very important, but because it's Emma is responsible for clearing the space under the basket for him. So it's very good move for big guys. Let's repeat again. But should be five players move. So when I start here, nobody can help. If he goes to help, he's alone on the 45 degree. Same situation from this side. If I'm trying from here, stay on your man, you go to help. Some coach like this. Again, just one step away from defense. If he goes to help on him, okay? If he goes to help on him, pass to him, easy. And same situation, let's go back. Same situation with the post from the driving from the help side. So if I'm driving above the post line, he moves in the short corner. Now in this situation again go this way because you're going here if I'm driving in the middle. So here I can pass here. I prefer more bounce pass than lob pass. Or just he can stay. Just stay here on the corner, pass here again. You should move in the corner when I drive here. Let's show again. Let's try to do you. Okay, move in the corner, we drive in the middle. Emma, don't be late. You should be already here. Immediately with the dribble, you should start. It's just walking, but timing is key. In this situation, like you can see, you don't need some special physical preparation for that. You don't need to lift 220 kilos bench press to do it. Mini basket is enough. So just a couple of moves with good spacing and with good time. Let's try to find him under the basket, never move here. Let's go. Or this way. So he do it good now. As soon as he start to help, you should pass the ball. Oh no, no. Well, now you go on me, you go to cover and pass the ball to him. Okay, just to show the coach some options. Now who can guard him? Nobody. In the end, just one strawberry of the cake is after that pass to make sprint. I can already show you. Let's do it again. Do it again the same. So if I'm trying here, I pass the ball and I close one here. Now he has only considered full to shoot the ball. A lot of space. So next situation. Same situation from the corner. Remember, penetration above the post line or post level. Post goes in the short corner. One, same side or opposite side. Even if I'm drawing from here, you do the same. So if he goes to jump here, I pass to him like this. Or if I'm going here, I pass the ball to him. Because nobody can tell. Let's now, after my drive, you go to help him. And you go this way. Because in this situation, it's very important to teach last player to open passing line. So like I show you before, he cannot be at the same line. If this guy staying on the same position, let's do like this. So stop, just be there. So in this situation, he don't need to go in the corner, go in the corner. So now he covered two players. So in this situation, it's up to him to move just a couple of steps there, like I showed you before. Help side, open passing line. He can see, big guy cannot see from behind. So if big guy is staying on this position, you stay on this position there. But if big guy is going here on this position, you are now in corner. Watch now situation. And of course, after that, when he passed the ball over there, boom, you immediately shoot. Because we don't want to have only outside yet. Okay. Also inside the end, in a good space for him. Let's try to do now. Let's try to find big guy. So try to go here and after that go back on the side. You can pass the ball to him, to him or to her on the 45 degree. Let's try to play normal defense to see if they are able to find good solution. Let's go. Not bad. Let's go. Now you change who will go to help. Okay? Change rotation, you and him. Okay? You and him, last two players, you change. Go to help on him and you go there. Try to find her. And you turn flash to the ball again. Let's go. Pass the ball and watch out. Pass to him, corner, and now again the guy here. So you should put the ball under the basket because this is our idea. Next, last situation, last option. Penetration below the post line. If we penetrate below the post line, post slides on the high post. Let's start from this position. Go, stay on the middle post. So in this situation, if I drive here, I want to see your reaction. Okay? What do you need to do if I'm going here? Behind me. You, here, Emma, space line pass, you should be on the corner and you go over there or inside. So from this position, if I try it here, this is a good one. So again, four situations. If they close me well, here and he close here, easy to shoot. If he can't recover, pass to him, go in the middle big man. So good spacing for him. So if the penetration goes below the post line, you go high post. Same situation from corner. Go back to defense. If I'm driving baseline, I want to see your moves now. Okay? No? Baseline, no baseline. We say baseline plus adjustment. So you should be there, you cut in the middle, you should be there, you are here. Just one step open pass line. So from this position, post goes here without the dribble, just left hand. So penetration below the post line, post switch up. Same situation from here. Same situation, you should be in the corner because this is also baseline drive. You go behind, you just stay because you cannot go there to make the trouble. If he goes to help, easy for you to shoot the ball, but nobody comes to help from the first pass. But in this situation, of course, if he comes to help to me, super. This is a good. Watch now the last player. He's between two. Okay, let's go now, try to close him. Go this way. So watch just last player, because with first drive, you should put the last defensive player on the help side between two offensive players. And like I already said, the last name decides position. So, from here, if he goes for help, easy pass for him. Just follow your man in the corner, okay? Or if he goes for help, easy pass under the basket. So, after that, of course, it's up to you to organize drills. I already showed you yesterday with the perimeter guys some drills tomorrow, also in the session connecting specific physical preparation and shooting. I will show you a couple of drills also for that, but this is the key. Now, let's start from the beginning to make my curriculum of this session. First, player without the ball, put the ball on the point guard. With teammate in the corner, three options. If he plays bad defense, just he can't move here. If he has just hand on the passing line, three steps getting open, receive the ball and attack him, go back. Foot and hand on the passing line, back to the counter. Go back. Emma, please move. With space on his side, V-cut. Attack the basket immediately. Be ready to receive the ball on his shooting range. L-cut. With a lot of options. This is the for this situation. Right? Go back, Emma. Pass and attack. Give and go. Pass. If he moves here, go in the middle. Go back. If he jumps to the basket, just go back, up and down. And if he jumps to the ball, back to the cut. All five positions if you play with five outside players, same goal. Next situation, it was passing with a post. So, low post, cut to the elbow, be ready to receive late pass under the basket. Go to high post. High post, running here on the first passing line, free space for him to play 1-on-1. Collaboration with post, go in the middle post, the low post. If defender traps, just move. Don't let him be on the same, place when he move back. So if he play yo-yo defense on this side, attack his back. Moving here or flashing to the ball. If you play when I pass the ball, pass to me. Jump to the ball and play this. So now just move here. Banana cut around 3-point line. This is collaboration with the post. Help side. If you remember well the rules, stay on the help side. Open passing line. Receive the ball with jump stop. One contact stop, reads. First, read, receive, and after that, attack. So, watch which hand and shoulder are up, attack his back. If he is late, shoot the ball. If he has hands here, shoot the ball again. And after that, circle move with adjustments on the baseline. So, just on the baseline, we should have player in the corner or opposite side of the drive, above the post. Penetration above the post line, post goes to the short corner, one side or second side. Penetration below the post line, post goes up. And even if you play something different, just I want to show you 2 minutes, you know. Pass the ball to me. So, let's come to play pick and roll with me. Okay, now. Same situation, circle ball. When I drive in the middle, he rolls to the basket, he goes over there, and Emma is going. So now, very good space, pass to him, or pass to her, and find him under the basket. Let's try just to do it one more time. Try to play pick and roll and try to find good solution. First option for you, if they don't play good, score. After that, watch him, and after that, watch all other three players. Let's try to play just to see how it's important to move without ball. So, So you can see how good spacing it was. In this situation, stop now. Of course, this is not main topic. Try to see now. If we want to put the ball under the basket, so let's do the same again. When I say stop, stop. Okay, he jumps here. Watch now. Watch now. You want to take position. We want the ball over there. To switch the ball to Emma and pass to you. So, because you should watch this guy. You understand? If he's like this, I told you before, if you stay like this, now you will pass the ball to him. And now you jump to the ball when the ball comes to you. But same move like before. Let's try to find a good solution. Okay, let's go now. You go to help on him. After pick and roll, you find Emma. Emma pass the ball under the basket. It's classical rotation in all kinds of the... You should move up. So, if he goes to check, watch now. Watch now. Now, after that, you just help and go back. Okay, let's go again. Why is good this? Because if he goes to help on this side, let's go. Let's go to help. So, in this situation, watch him now. In this situation, he rolls, but watch his position. Pass the ball, you go back, and you are now in front. So, it's your job to read the situation of the defender. If he jumps, if he makes hard jumps, move ball there, and after that, pass the ball to him. Okay? Let's go again. So, usually you should help and go back. Okay? Because you cannot let him shoot. It's great. It's a pretty good shooter. Let's go. And watch now. We have excellent situation for big guy. Same circle move like before. One more thing that we have here. Just one more exception. In this situation, when dribble drive is going from this side, so what she need to do, depending on the defense. If defenders, sometimes in youth program you can find a lot of time that helps come from the first pass. If he goes immediately to help, of course, Emma, you just move one step or there or back door, let's say now outside. So, early help from the first side, he goes up, just stay in the corner. Just stay in the corner and be away from him. And second option is, if helps come later, in this situation, don't stop immediately, stop me over there. In this situation, you should go here. So now, if he wants to help me here, this is easy job. So in this situation, it's better for her to go to make safety pass than to be here. Of course, after that, it's up to players to decide to read situation, but generally, you should start with classical circle move. Same situation, let's show, for example, courts. Let's play with two big guys. It doesn't matter who is. Same circle move. So not just you roll under the basket. A lot of teams use that. So if you start to play that, same circle move. Okay, I'm moving here. You roll to the basket. Watch now him. He moves. She stays on the corner. Good spacing. If you start to play immediately or later, or usually coach do it first. One screen between two big guys, but I don't want to speak about it. This is the senior basketball, but I want to show you that even in that level, if you use circle move, you can have some advantage. Of course, let's play like this, circle move. You open out, you stay wide, you go to help on me, Emma, backdoor cut, or here, if some defense plays like this, if this is the player on position four, it's completely different. So, it doesn't matter if you start to play with five outside players, if you play with four out, one in, or three out, two in. Always we have dribble drive. So, because of that, I think it's very important to start to teach kids. In mini basket, you can start to run drills with two, three players. Same situation, just make isolation with two players. After that, in under 12, believe me, they can be able to do it without any problem, without any screen, just motion offense with penetration and kick with circle move. So, thank you very much to them. of course, after that, it's up to you to use or not.
Of course.
Always the same. Give me the same situation like I showed you before. Of course, you cannot start to go back, please, just 1 minute. So go 5 players out, like I showed you before. Point guard, I'm starting to move here. They start to circle more. When I change, okay, change direction. So always change, doesn't matter if you start from this position or this. So in the end, you can put the tape on the court with 5 or 6 positions, and after that, just fill open spot, nothing else. It's simple. It's really simple for them, so move always on the dribble there, and I think that should be first part of motion offense. First part of motion offense. Of course, before driving kick, we should have individual technique and tactic of stopping, driving, passing, sliding, and after that we can start to work with 2 players, with 3 players, 2 outside players, 1 in, 1 out. 3 out, 3 players, so I will show you in shooting session some drills, some interesting drills for that, but after that it's easy for you. Just choose to take 2 players and fall. Me and them, we start to do. First drill, go back door, for example. After that, she starts to dribble. Can be first practice, first drill of the practice. Let's go. Without defense, let's go out. Let's go out. Just you and me, let's go. Start from corner. Go to dribble, I am receiving the ball here, when I receive, drive. Can be also shooting drill in the end of the practice. So, it's up to you. With 2 players, with 3 players, so after that we have some different situations. For example, now, we say before, depending on the level of the basketball. If he stays with the ball here, I think in senior basketball is much better to be on the corner, don't go to make backdoor cut. But with the kids, it's better to go to make backdoor cut. So, after that, like I showed you before, this is not a circle move against late help. Go to drive in the middle, when he comes to close over there, it's better for me not to wait here, but be here. So, I'm too far from defense, way away from defense. But after that, this is the next level. And in the end, you should give also the players some freedom to read situation, because this is not definitely a video game. But some basic rules, some basic moves we should cover with the 5-5 circle move. Any more question? Okay. Thank you very much again, first players, and also to you.